definitely in America, we have an issue with kids and their weight and just like their, you know, connectedness with their body. Capoeira, you have to move all parts of your body in all different directions. So, you know, it's building body awareness, fitness, you know, self-defense, confidence, because we make them do so many things in front of each other, in front of an audience, in the hodo, they have to sing, they have to clap. So it's a whole cultural thing. They learn about themselves, they learn how to be social.
We perform a lot in a recreation center in over the city. So we teach free classes for the kids not be able to pay. We focus in kids, but we help a lot of adults too. So, but it's specific to the kids because kids is gonna be our future. For, you know, I wanna make sure they keep it going. So.
The kids have a chance to do better because they don't have like the fear of hurting themselves. You know, they'll go upside down, like, ah, you know.
The music is the soul of capoeira. The berimbau is the stick, the main thing in capoeira. We have the tambourine, the copandeiro. We have the jingle bell called agogô. We have a lot of percussion. And besides this, music where we tell a message for the players, even for the people around. We send a message, like they have one specific, like in Brazil a long time ago, you cannot do this in the street. By the time you do the street, you starting doing the street, but the guy, the master in the berimbau, they keep you look around to see if the cops come, the policemen come. If they come, we change the rhythm of the berimbau, we change the song. Is capoeira working like improvisation and different martial arts not? For each attack, you have a specific defense. With capoeira, we don't have this. Whatever you do, I need to prepare myself. I don't know where the kick is coming from, and I have to have my improvisation to defend myself and attack.
Philadelphia, you want to do capoeira. You definitely want to do it.